Thank you. Just like Victoria Moon said, the medallion fit. It was the master key that unlocked the Egyptian sarcophagus. And when it opened up, it smelled a little bit like my dirty socks. The room was flooded with a strange green light, and mysterious bolts of lightning slammed into Belzoni, Jeff, and me. We were being transformed by an ancient curse. It melted Jeff and Belzoni into a single creature. As for me, where was my beautiful face? Whose idea was it to turn me into a crocodile with leopard arms? I quickly switched back to normal, but the transformation would happen again if the curse wasn't lifted. Luckily, Victoria Moon knew how to do it. We had to find a fabled relic, the Emerald Tablet. The map that would lead us to it was in the bowels of the Louvre, in the office of the last Egyptologist who had it in his hands 200 years ago, Dominic Vivantinan. Just then, Ramirez and Pickle, International Heritage Defense agents, turned up. We hadn't left a single crime uncommitted in our break-in at the university. And even though our intention was to explain ourselves, we decided to stick to our plan, to go to Paris and find the map. The thing is, now we have to do it by fleeing the scene. Victoria covered everyone's travel expenses. She seemed very keen to get her hands on the Emerald Tablet. Even more than I was, since I had turned back into an animal. So my friends had to disguise me as their pet and put me in the hold of the plane. She also got the lorry that we drove to the Louvre. At that point, I should have begun to suspect her intentions. But I was so worried about my physical form, I didn't think twice about it. We decided to split up once we got to the Louvre. Ted went straight to check out the Department of Egyptian Antiquities, while I wanted to make a few improvements to certain works of art.